Hey guys, what is going on? My name is Yin, and today I've got a conglomerate of iPhone models, once again, for another episode of Chip Contest. This is a series where we take a look at all the recent processors that Apple has made and compare them against each other. So if you want to see where your device is along this hierarchy of processors, then this is going to get real interesting real quick. Because, hey, what the?
Is this 2020?
Yeah, it's April. 2020. So?
Crap!
Now, it definitely would not be a chip contest without a strange array of iPhones here on my table. Of course, we're starting with the original iPhone SE. It's got the A9 processor, which is the oldest iPhone processor supported on iOS 13. Next, the iPhone 7 with the A10 Fusion, first with 4 cores. Why is this one so beat up? The iPhone 10 with the A11 Bionic. First with 6 cores, beautiful skin by D brand on the back, iPhone XR a fan favorite with the A12 Bionic, and the iPhone 11 with the A13 Bionic. Each of these are one generation ahead of the previous one in their processing power, though some of these chips appeared in other devices first. Now of course these chips also represent other devices that contain the exact same processor. So if your device is on this list, then these results will speak for you as well. Now of course these don't count the iPad Pro versions of these chips, the X variants and now the Z variants. Those are generally going to have better CPU and GPU performance across the board. As per tradition, I went back in time and got help from my past selves. I hope this doesn't break any timelines or anything. That's me from 2014 over there and the me from 2017, respectively. Now, I have asked them nicely to not speak during this video.
What? No.
I told them not to speak.
Rude?
Fine. I yelled at them, okay? To shut their traps. Is this what you wanted?
Yes.
Yeah,
whatever. It's not like they're gonna remember this anyway. Moving on. All right, let's go ahead and head to the speed lab to perform our first test. It's gonna be the Ookla Wi-Fi speed test. Of course, these tests were performed separately to avoid clogging up the bandwidth. The iPhone 11 is the first device out of these iPhones that supports Wi-Fi 6, but I don't think you'll really see that much of a difference in real life use, especially if your service provider or your router doesn't support it. Now for my Wi-Fi network, it's normal to hit that 150 to 170 megabits per second range, and we're really kind of seeing that, with a few devices dipping a little lower than usual. But honestly, there's not enough variance to really make that much of an impact on your daily use. Maybe with the exception of the iPhone SE, since that score is quite a bit lower. Alright, moving on. Next up, let's go ahead and test the CPU speed in a test inside of Geekbench 5. Basically, this tool measures how much raw processing power each device has. The higher the score, the better. This is really what you'll see in your day-to-day performance, how snappy your phone feels, how quickly it opens apps. And of course, the iPhone 11 is first with 2 minutes and 13 seconds, followed shortly by the iPhone XR and the iPhone 7. Seems the iPhone 10 is lagging behind a little bit. It finally finishes with 2 minutes and 41 seconds. And here's where we see the A9 start to show its age a little bit. It is 5 years old, finally finishing at 3 minutes and 1 second. Now, it is normal to see Apple processors double in CPU performance every 2 years, which is exactly what happened between the A9 and A11. The iPhone 10 is more than twice as powerful than the SE. But then the next 3 processors, the Bionic series, really did not have that sort of double in performance. Based on that pattern, the iPhone 11's multi-core score should be around 5,000 rather than what it is now. And that brings us to our next test, which is the graphics performance test inside of Geekbench, the compute benchmark. Because historically, iPhones really have not had the best GPUs. They've used third-party GPUs up until Apple started designing them with the A11 chip. And I'd wager with rumors of high refresh displays coming to the next iPhone models, Apple's really doubling down on their graphics performance. So of course the iPhone 11 finished first with a massive score of 6273. The iPhone XR follows shortly behind with 4492. The iPhone X is next with 3314, followed shortly by the iPhone 7, and this is where we start to see that the previous GPUs really did not differ that much from one generation to the next. With the A10 and A11, it was a 500 point difference. And finally, with the A9 chip coming in with a 600 point difference. So as you guys can see with the Bionic series, the graphics performance gains by over 1,000 points every generation instead of about 500 in the previous models. Let's actually run another graphics test. This is the Antutu Benchmark. This application tests graphics performance on screen, whereas the Compute Benchmark really focused on behind the scenes. As you guys can see, the iPhone 11 is taking the lead. 10R is not very far behind, but the 10, the 7, and the SE, they're dropping frames everywhere. So if you're talking about pure graphical performance, the A13 and A12 are miles ahead of the other chips. So taking a look at the results here, this is where the doubling every 2 years rule really seems to shine. The iPhone X doubles that of the SE, and the iPhone 11 almost doubles the iPhone X, which is pretty nice. Now the iPhone XR is not very far behind the iPhone 11, so honestly, if you had to save money and get the XR, you're not really missing out much on graphics performance. When it comes to these processors, it really seems like we're just going down the line in order of processing power. Sometimes there's an exception or two.
Hey, you got a message.
Yeah, I know. Don't touch that. Those are my text messages. No, don't stop typing. Stop. You don't know these people yet. How are they gonna know? It's not me.
Fine.
I'm gonna finish recording the talking head, then we'll talk.
Fine.
Now let's move on to our next test, which is testing how fast apps will open when you tap on them. Now all the applications are logged into the same accounts, they have the same data. So if each device was to load the exact same app, starting with YouTube, and it looks like we're just going right down the line. And for some reason, the iPhone XR seems to not like Justine. Seems to have rejected her on the homepage there, but anyways. Let's move on to opening our next application, which is Disney Plus, going in 3, 2, 1. It looks like there was a tiny bit of stutter on the iPhone XR, but in the end, it looks like we just went straight down the line anyways. And let's go ahead and launch Twitter, and wow, a little scattered, but pretty much within a second of each other. All right, next up, I wanted to test the speed differences between 3D touch and haptic touch. Here, the iPhone X and the iPhone 7 both have 3D touch, while the SE, the XR, and the 11 do not. So the goal of this test is to see if the better processing power in the newer devices makes up for the time you save on a device with 3D touch. So let's start with the Notes app. The test begins as soon as my finger hits the screen and ends when the app first becomes usable. First test, very interesting, 3D touch devices actually coming in last. Now let's move on to the camera app, going directly to the selfie camera. Looks like the 3D touch devices have an advantage here. So I guess part of this depends on which application you're trying to open as well. Anyways, let's go ahead and do one more of this test. We're gonna head straight to the update section of the App Store to update some applications. Personally, it doesn't look like you're losing a whole lot of time sacrificing 3D touch. So if I had to give that up for better battery life, then I would. Now this actually leads into our next test, which is how fast these phones can update and install applications that come through the App Store. I have all these same updates loaded up, Snapchat, Twitter, B&H, and Starbucks. First one to install all of them wins, and we are off. So let's go ahead and see which one of these installs these applications quicker. Looks like the iPhone 11 comes in with a huge advantage over the others, then the XR, the 7, then the 10, then the SE. Kind of a strange pattern, but not very big differences between them. And let's move on to our last set of tests, which is loading web pages. So with all the multitasking on each device cleared out, of course, we gotta do the apple.com in 3, 2, 1. All three Bionic chips do exceptionally well, but the difference between them is pretty negligible. Next up, let's go to imdb.com on each of these devices. Starting in 3, 2, 1. This is a much more content-heavy site, and it looks like it looks like the pattern is pretty inverted here with the iPhone X coming in last. I'm actually kind of disappointed in the iPhone X right now. Last but not least, the office of the internet, reddit.com, home of the best comment sections on the internet. And it looks like the iPhone X and the iPhone XR pull ahead. There is definitely a difference between these devices. Honestly, I think the results are pretty mixed this time around. Now, based on the results of this video, I don't see enough difference between each chip to want to upgrade to the next one. You'd have to jump a few generations. And of course, these tests don't really count the unique features that newer processors can provide, such as better image processing, which translates into drastically better cameras, especially on the A13 processor. So if you're looking to upgrade your devices, I would recommend going for a device with the A12 chip or the A13 chip. I would not recommend the A11 or below. The A9 and A10 are getting pretty old now. The A11 still works fine, but it's not very efficient. But if you already have a device with the A12 or A13, I don't think you'll have to worry about upgrading for at least another 3 or 4 years. They're just that good. Okay, editing again here. I don't think I've ever owned an iPhone 7. So I'm not entirely sure where this one came from, or why it's so beat up. Unless... What the? Right. Never mind. Alright, so what do you guys think about this comparison? Make sure you let me know in the comment section below. Be sure to hit that subscribe button and that bell if you want to see more stuff like this, and I will see you in the next one.